Welcome friends, today we are going to be making Swiss meringue buttercream, which is my favorite icing and most frequently used because it's not too sweet. We'll be using liquid egg whites and granulated sugar. I'm putting 2 cups of sugar into a bowl of my stand mixer and 1 cup of liquid egg whites. You can also use fresh egg whites by separating the egg whites from the yolks. So I'll have a pot of boiling water. So I'll put the bowl over the pot, making sure the bottom of the bowl doesn't touch the water. So I'll stir that with my whisk until the sugar is fully dissolved. I test that with my finger to make sure there are no sugar granules. And then I transfer the bowl to my mixer, and using my whisk attachment, I beat the mixture until it's nice and thick. If I add my butter, so I'm adding a teaspoon of vinegar just to help stabilize the egg whites. You can use any acid like vinegar or lemon juice or cream of tartar to help stabilize the egg whites, especially in this case where they are the liquid egg whites from the box and they're pasteurized. So I'll keep beating that until the mixture is thickened and until it's cold, so it's not too warm. If it's too warm, the butter is gonna melt and I'm adding it. I'm using 2 cups of butter in this case. So I'll keep whisking and checking until the mixture is thick and a little bit stiff. That's what we call the meringue. A mixture of egg whites and granulated sugar. When the meringue is thick, we're going to add the butter to make a buttercream, Swiss meringue buttercream. So I stop the whisk to check if the mixture is thick, thickened and stiff, and then I touch the sides of the bowl to make sure it's not too hot, not warm to touch. Then I start adding the butter in little bits and beating. You can add the butter in cubes, you can cut it into cubes or add a tablespoon at a time. Just add a little bit at a time so the mixture doesn't get too overwhelmed. You don't overwhelm the meringue with the fat with the butter. One thing I forgot to mention is that the bowl, before you start the meringue process, the bowl and the whisk have to be completely clean and free of any fat. So if you had used it previously for mixing cake or icing, you need to wash it really well. Because if there's any fat in the bowl, the meringue is not going to stiffen or thicken as it's supposed to. So sometimes I wipe the bowl with a little bit of vinegar or lemon juice just to make sure there's no fat in the bowl before we start the process. So I keep adding the butter in little bits until I add the whole 2 cups of butter. At this point, you might get a little worried because the mixture will look kind of, sometimes it looks soupy or just too curdled. It doesn't look smooth. So you might get worried and think your icing is getting bad, but just keep whipping and adding the butter until the butter is all done, and then you whip a little longer until it's nice and creamy. At this point, I'm just beating it at medium high speed. So I've just increased the speed to high, about 8, and keep beating. At this point, I've added all the butter, so I'll increase the speed and beat until it's a nice smooth mixture. I'm just going to lift the whisk and then scrape the sides and bottom of the bowl to get off any butter anything that is stuck to the bottom, so the mixture is nice and well combined. And we'll keep beating on high speed for at least 5 minutes until everything is well incorporated and the icing is nice and smooth. No curdles, no liquid, just a nice smooth icing. Then I'm adding some vanilla to give it a nice vanilla flavor. You can always add any flavor you like, but my go-to is usually vanilla. So I've added about a tablespoon of vanilla and I'm beating on high until I get a nice smooth consistency. Now I've changed the attachment to the paddle attachment from the whisk attachment. So towards the end I changed it to the paddle attachment to just beat it again and get out any air bubbles, because the whisk usually incorporates a lot of air into the icing. So the paddle attachment will kind of break off those air bubbles and also help the icing to be nice and smooth and creamy. I'm beating that on high speed for about 2 more minutes until it's nice and smooth. I just love Swiss meringue buttercream. It's so creamy, so smooth, so light, and above all, not too sweet. I just love that part. I don't like overly sweet cakes or icings, as I always say. So now you can see how nice and creamy and smooth the icing looks. You can use this on cupcakes, on cakes, any cake of your choice. As you have already noticed in the video, there's no icing sugar in this icing, so it's not too sweet and it doesn't have that greedy feeling of taste of the icings you make with icing sugar. See how smooth and creamy that looks? That just melts in your mouth and you put it on a cake or cupcake or any other thing. So yeah, in this case I iced these beautiful cupcakes with the icing, and I use it for most of my cakes because I don't like them too sweet. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.